All right, Shalom. I want to start off by giving our praises to the Heavenly Father through His Son, which the world ignorantly called God in Jesus Christ, through the Holy Spirit. So, Kahala Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahweh, Ba'ashem Rekal Kadash, double honors to the Apostles of Great Millstone that rule well, who received this truth from through the Spirit, and Shalom to the brothers that labor in this gospel in truth and sincerity. All right, this is Power Thumb, back with another lesson through the Spirit. And this lesson, I want to get into the problem, the reaction, and the solution. The answers to our people questions, all right, which our people always ask, why are we going through this? Why are we catching all this hell? All right? And that's, you know, one indicator showing you the children of Israel are, because the Israelites, they desire the truth, but the only the elect will receive the truth. All right, so this is Romans 11:7. It says, what then? Israel had not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blinded. So 2/3 of our people will not understand, all right, and get the, they will not understand why they're in this position, all right, as receiving these curses, but the election will obtain it, all right. And the rest of Israel will be blinded from the truth, all right? God, people seeking for the truth, but they will not find it, because the Most High blinded them, you know, and the Most High woke up the elect, all right? He gave them the spirit of understanding to be able to see and to hear these things, okay? So we're going to get into the problem, all right? The problem with our people is not a carnal problem, but is indeed a spiritual problem. All right, this is Baruch 1:17. It says, for we have sinned before the Most High. And what is sin? Sin is transgression of the law. All right, that's what sin is, transgression of the law. So if you break the law, you sin against the Most High. All right, and the law was only given to the Israelites. Let me get that right quick. Psalms 147:18-19 It says, he showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He had not dealt so with any nation. As for his judgments, they have not known them. Praise ye Yahweh. So the Most High only gave his law, statutes, and commandments to the Israelites, the 12 tribes of Israel, all right, which those laws they broke. So for that agreement being broken, they had to be punished. This Amos 3:1. Hear this word that Yahweh has spoken against you, O children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. All right? And how has the Most High only known the Israelites? By giving them his way. All right? His laws, his statutes, and his commandments. In the previous verse we just read, verse 20, it said, he had not dealt so with any nation. All right? And as for his judgments, they have not known them. Because he only gave them to the Israelites. All right? That's how he knew us. It says, therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities. All right? So the Lord punished us for our transgression. Therefore, these curses that's written here in Deuteronomy 28 had come upon us. Deuteronomy 28:15, it says, but it shall come to pass, if thou would not hearken unto the voice of Yahweh, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. All right? So for our disobedience and us being hard-headed, the Most High put curses upon us. All right? And I'll just read some of these curses. Deuteronomy 28:43, it says, the stranger, talking about all these other heathen nations that is within thee, shall get up above thee very high, and thou shalt come down very low. And these heathen are high. Starting with Esau Edom, the self-proclaimed white people, they high, man. They have control of the laws, all right? They have control of resources, all right? They control these things. And under Esau, you have these other heathen nations. They're like supervisors over us under Esau, all right? They carry his idea forward, all right, of oppressing us and building up his kingdom. All right, so the strangers, they are very high. They have stores in your neighborhood, all right? They control the sports that you play, all right? They own the teams. You just play for them, okay? And it says, thou shalt come down very low. And we are very low. We in the hoods. You don't see the nation of Esau in the hoods like you see the nation of Israel in the hood. You don't see Moab in the hood. You don't see Ishmael in the hood or Elam in the hood. All right? And those are their true identities. All right? Moab being the Chinaman, the Arabs, Ishmael, Elam, East Indians. They in your neighborhood, but only to exploit you. Only to take advantage of you. Only to get your money, your hard-earned money, all right? And take it back to their neighborhoods and send it to their people in other countries, all right? Verse 45, it says, moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of Yahweh thy power. So while we destroyed, because we hard-headed, man, as a nation, all right? It says, to keep his commandments and his statutes, which he commanded thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder and upon thy seed forever. And these curses have taken hold of us, all right, for a sign. That's how we're able to identify who the Israelites are, based off of the curses and the blessings that have been placed upon them. All right? Because no other nation has took part of these curses like the nation of Israel have. All right? So this is, Hosea 4 and 6. This is, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. All right? And I'm not talking about, the scriptures are not talking about the knowledge of Kemet, the knowledge of Esau, the knowledge of science, falsely so-called, the knowledge of his technology, all right? Talking about the knowledge of these scriptures, all right? It says, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me, sin thou hast forgotten the law of thy power. I will also forget thy children. And that's why we are here in this captivity today, all right? This is Baruch chapter 3 and verse 8. It says, behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, all right, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse. But we have been scattered in these other nations. We are reproached. We are hated. Everywhere you go, you look down upon as you don't belong there, all right, and a curse, and to be subject to payments. All right, we are subject to payments, all these bills, each and every day. All right, before you get your check, you taxed out the ass. All right, before you get your money, he already taken it away from you. All right, that's a slave right there. Okay, it says according to all the iniquities of their fathers. So why this is happening is because our disobedience. This is the problem with our people, and the reaction from the Heavenly Father, all right? It says, which departed from the Lord our power. And this is the solution right here in verse 9 on down. Hear, Israel, the commandment of life. Give ear to understand wisdom. How happened it, Israel, that thou art in thine enemy's land? So how did this happen? How did the great Israelites, all right, that was delivered from delivered from Egypt with a great chariot, all right, and the Heavenly Father being with them, and they becoming a great nation, all right, under David and King Solomon. How are you yet this day in your captivity, all right, in your enemy's land. It says that thou art waxing old in a strange country, because our land, which was given by oath to Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, how are we not in that land, man? All right, the land of Israel. It says that thou art defiled with the dead, that thou art counted with them that go down into the grave. And we're being murdered by the numbers, man. We're being slaughtered to the point to where our people got to chant, hands up, don't shoot, marching in the streets, which that's not the solution, all right? Verse 12, it says, thou hast forsaken the fountain of wisdom. For if thou hadst walked in the way of the Most High, thou shouldest have dwelt in peace forever. Learn where is wisdom. This is the solution. Learn where is wisdom, where is strength, where is understanding, that thou mayest know also where is length of days. So get into this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Follow up under Yahweh Bashem Yahushua through his teachers, all right, through his prophets, through the men that he has set up, through the pastors in Jeremiah 3 and 15. He said he will give you pastors according to his heart, which is his mind, that shall feed you with wisdom and understanding, roughly paraphrasing it. Okay, it says, in life, and where is the light of the eye in peace? All right? So this is Baruch 4 and 6. It says, ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because ye moved the Most High to wrath. Ye were delivered into the enemies. All right? So jumping down, it says, verse 18, for he that brought these plagues upon you would deliver you from the hands of your enemies. Verse 21, be of good cheer, O my children. Cry unto the Most High. We have to cry, and the elect are crying, and they will be crying. According to Isaiah 62 and 4, it says, get the Most High no rest until he make Jerusalem a praise in the earth. So we ought to be praying. We ought to be putting up videos. The men, the leaders of the nation, ought to be out there on the highways and the byways as commanded. All right, crying unto the Heavenly Father and praying, man. Asking for this to Most High to speed this thing up to where Yahweh Shah can come and deliver us and destroy our enemies, man. Because America will be destroyed and it's soon to come, man. All right? It says, and we'll deliver you from the power and hand of the enemy. Our main enemy here is so-called white people, starting with the elite, all right, the nation of Edom, all right? The Most High is going to take Esau down, man, all right? 2 Ezra 6 and 9 says, Esau is the end of the world, an end of an age, an end of an uninterrupted rulership, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. So we're going to follow up Esau in righteousness, all right? And it's going to be an everlasting kingdom. Verse 22, for my hope is in the everlasting, that he will save you, and joy is come unto me from the Holy One, because the mercy which shall soon come unto you from the everlasting, our Savior. And Yahweh is going to send his son to deliver us on those chariots with the angels, man. All right? He said, for I sent you out with mourning and weeping, but the Most High will give you to me again with joy and gladness. Like as now the neighbors of Zion have seen your captivity, so shall they see shortly your salvation from the Most High, our power, which shall come upon you with great glory and brightness from the everlasting. Yahweh Shai is coming in glorious fashion. All right? He's coming to deliver and to destroy. To destroy the wicked and to deliver the righteous. And the righteous only consist of the elect of the nation of Israel. All right? And he coming to destroy Esau and anyone that follows after Esau, man. All right? Including two-thirds of our people. Verse 25. But in the kingdom, our people will be all righteous. All right? In the kingdom, our people will be good. They will be born out of the loins of the elect. And there will be our righteous program to be right. All of us will. All right? Forever. Verse 25. My children, suffer patiently the wrath that is come upon you from the Most High. And this is the mindset we ought to be in, that we will suffer patiently, all right, the wrath, all right, these curses that we under. that has come upon us from the Most High. See, the Bible has the answers to all the questions, all right? To why we suffering, why we going through what we go through. The Most High put the Spirit on men to write it all down, man. And in the last days, these questions will be answered through the Spirit, man. All right? For the elect, it says, "For thy enemy hath prosecuted thee, but shortly thou shalt see his destruction and shall tread upon his neck." And all praises call Allah to Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai. Because Esau Edom going to have to pay for what he's done, man. All right? Vengeance is coming, man. All praises. So with that, I want to give